Introduction to numbers from 6 to 9.
Hello friends, I am the parrot. Welcome to this lesson. Let's see what you will learn in this lesson. Counting from 6 to 9. Today there is a religious ceremony at Choto's house. He notices a bowl of laddus kept on the table. On the other side of the table, Choto's mother is making a garland of flowers.
Mom, I'm feeling very hungry. Can I eat all these laddus?
No, son. There are a lot of laddus. If you eat so many laddus, your stomach will start aching.
Oh, well, how many laddus are there in this bowl?
Choto, I'm very busy right now. Count and tell how many laddus are there.
Okay, Mom. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. This means there are 5 laddus in this bowl, right?
Children, did Choto count the laddus in the bowl properly? Let us see.
Very good, Choto. Now you can eat 2 out of these 5 laddus.
1 and 2. Thank you, Mom.
So, children, like Choto, you also know numbers from 1 to 5, right? Let us now see how we count something if it is more than 5 in number.
Mom, may I also help you in making the garland?
Yes, why not, Choto? But first tell me how many flowers are there in this garland?
Okay, Mom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and a few more.
How many more?
I don't know that. How will you count the rest of the flowers?
Let me help you in this. With these 5 flowers, if we bring 1 more flower, it will become 6 flowers. This means there are 6 flowers. Then if we bring another flower, then it will become 7. That means 7 flowers. Then with these 7 flowers, if we bring another flower, it will become 8. That means 8 flowers. And then if we bring the last flower, it will become 9. That means 9 flowers. So do you understand?
Yes, Mom.
Come on now. You count yourself and tell me how many flowers are there in the garland.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. That means there are 9 flowers.
Very good, Choto. Now it is time for the religious ceremony. Wash your hands and come quickly.
So children, can you also count till 9 like Choto? That was all for today. In this video, we learned to count 9 flowers. In the next video, we will see some examples of numbers from 6 to 9. Till then, goodbye friends.
Interesting example part 1.
So children, in the previous video you learned to count 9 flowers. In this video, we will compare different numbers. Today Choto's mother is cleaning the refrigerator. She has kept all the items out of the refrigerator. Choto comes to help her.
Mom, can I help you to put all this stuff back in refrigerator?
Yes, Choto, why not? First, one by one, count each item and tell the number of that item.
Come on, let's count the number of these items with Choto.
Okay, Mom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. These are 6 eggs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. These are 7 bananas. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. These are 8 lemons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. These are 9 chilies.
Very good, Choto. You counted all the items correctly. Come on, now let's keep all these inside the refrigerator.
So children, did you also count the number of these items properly like Chotu? Now Chotu and his mother are going to bring their dried clothes from the terrace.
Chotu, can you tell me which one of these two wires has more clothes on them?
There are 6 clothes on this wire and 7 clothes on that wire. In numbers, 7 is more than 6. Therefore, there are more clothes on the second wire.
Very good, Chotu. You are absolutely right. Now let's look all the pots. Which of these pots has fewer flowers?
Can you count the number of flowers in these pots and tell which flower pot has fewer flowers? Come on, let's see what Chotu answers.
There are 8 flowers in that flower pot and 9 flowers in the other flower pot. In numbers, 8 is lesser than 9. Therefore, the first pot has fewer flowers.
Was your answer also the same?
Very good, Chotu. Once again, you are correct. Come on, now let us take all the dried clothes quickly and go back downstairs.
So children, that was all for today. In this video, we saw some examples of numbers from 6 to 9 in which we compared these numbers. In the next video, we will see some more examples and learn about some common mistakes and myths. Till then, goodbye friends!
Interesting example, part 2.
So children, in the previous video, you compared numbers. In this video, we will look at some more examples and learn where Chotu could go wrong in understanding these numbers. Today is a holiday and Chotu is cleaning his room along with his mother. While cleaning his desk, he accidentally drops his piggy bank. The piggy bank breaks and Chotu gets excited seeing so many coins in that.
Look, Mom, so many coins. I will buy a new toy for myself with these.
Yes, Chotu, but before buying a toy, you should know how many coins these are. Can you count these coins and tell me how many of them are there?
Yes, Mom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. That means there are 9 coins.
Children, did Chotu correctly count the number of coins? Let us see.
Son, you did not count the coins one by one. These are not 9 coins. Come on, count them again. One by one?
Alright, Mom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. This means these are 7 coins.
Yes, you are absolutely correct, dear. Come on, now write the number of these coins on this paper so that you may remember how many coins these are.
Here it is, Mom.
Chotu, you have written 7 in reverse. It is written correctly like this. Do you understand?
Yes, Mom.
Come on now, let us finish cleaning quickly.
Can you write numbers from 6 to 9 properly on a piece of paper? Be careful not to write any number in reverse like Chotu. While cleaning his room, Chotu finds a box of many color pencils.
Look, Mom, there are pencils of so many different colors. Can I draw a picture with them?
Yes, Chotu. These are 9 pencils. Take 6 pencils from them and draw a picture with them.
Okay, Mom.
Chotu takes all the pencils. Children, can you tell if Chotu has taken 6 pencils from the box or more or less than 6? Let us see.
Hey, Chotu, you have taken all the pencils. You have to take only 6 pencils, son.
Oh, okay, Mom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Is it okay now, Mom?
Yes, son. Very good. Now you make the drawing.
So, children, that was all in this topic. In this video, we learned how to correctly count and write the number of objects. I hope all of you understood this topic properly. Bye, friends.